Describe fully the locus of the points representing z, where z is a complex number, if z plus 2i divided by z minus 2i is purely imaginary. So this is a question of complex number. So we always start z in a general form is written as z is equal to x plus yi, or iy, so let me write x plus yi. So this is the general form of any complex number. So what they're saying is this is purely imaginary. So I'll come to explain this later. So let's only look at this. What does this mean? Z plus 2i divided by z minus 2i. So well, z plus 2i divided by z minus 2i. So let's substitute z as x plus yi. So this is x plus yi plus 2i divided by x plus yi yi minus 2i. Now the only thing is you have to be very careful when you are simplifying this type of expression. So let's write the real part and the imaginary part separately. So this is x plus y plus 2i, like this. I'm factoring the I out, divided by x plus y minus 2 times I. Now when you have a complex number in this form, to simplify this complex number, we need to multiply by the conjugate. So this is equal to, so the conjugate of the denominator, so this is x plus, let me put this in the bracket, y plus 2i times, multiplying by the conjugate of the denominator, is x minus y minus 2i, which is, this is the conjugate of the denominator. So multiplying the same thing in the denominator, so this is x plus y minus 2i times x minus, the conjugate of this is x minus y minus 2i. Now the next step is something that you can do yourself. You can pause this video and try to expand the numerator and denominator. So this expands, so if you expand the numerator, so this is x squared plus x times, or you got a minus here, so can I write like this, minus xi times y minus 2 plus xi times y plus 2. This is just expanding the numerator, and then you got a plus and minus, so this would be minus I squared times, I'm expanding y plus 2 times y minus 2 is y squared minus 4. To save space, I hope you understand the expansion, divided by, this is difference of two squares, so this is x plus y minus 2i times x minus y minus 2i. So it's basically x squared minus I squared times y minus 2 the whole squared. Now negative i squared you should know is negative 1. And that's the definition, because I is square root of negative 1. So simplifying this further, so this is x squared, expanding this further, so this is minus xyi, and you got a minus times minus is going to be plus 2xi, hopefully I'm not doing it wrongly, plus xyi plus xyi plus 2xi. And minus I squared is going to be plus 1. So that is plus y squared minus 4 divided by, this is again going to be plus 1 minus I squared is going to be plus 1. So the denominator is x squared plus y minus 2 the whole squared. Okay, so we're almost there. So now what can be cancelled? So this and this can be cancelled. Okay, and now what are we left with? So this is equal to x squared plus y squared minus 4 is the, so you got x squared from here and you got y squared minus 4 here, and this is plus 4xi divided by x squared plus y minus 2 the whole squared. So this is a simplified form, so we can separate the real and the imaginary part. So this is x squared plus y squared minus 4 divided by the denominator . So this is the real part, and the imaginary part is 4xi divided by x squared plus y minus 2 the whole squared. Okay, now let's go back to the question. What are they saying? They are telling us that this is purely imaginary. So this is purely imaginary means there is no real part. This means purely imaginary means the real part is equal to 0. So for this complex number, we have simplified this complex number to this form. So well, we can say if this is purely imaginary, this has to be 0. So I can set that equal to 0. So this is x squared plus y squared minus 4 divided by x squared plus y minus 2 the whole squared is equal to 0. So if something, if fraction is equal to 0, the denominator cannot be 0. So this implies, so you can say this implies the denominator cannot be 0, because if it is equal to 0, it is not defined. So we can say this is not equal to 0. So what is 0? So obviously the numerator has to be 0. So we can say, well, x squared plus y squared minus 4 has to be 0. That implies x squared plus y squared is equal to 4. Well, this is an equation of a circle with center. So this is an equation of a circle. So one thing, what is locus? Locus is a set of points with a particular, with a given character. So circle is a locus, because if you draw a circle, all the points are on the same or at the same distance. So what we are saying is this is a circle with center 0, 0, and the radius of 2. So let's go back to the question. What are they asking? So what they're saying is this is a complex number, and this is the condition that they have given, that this complex number is purely imaginary. So basically I started with z is equal to x plus y I, did a bit of algebra. This is where you have to be careful. And then this is the main part to understand that this is the condition, that this is purely imaginary. That means the real part has to be 0. So once you do the algebra, you're simplifying to this form, where this is the real part. This is the real part, and this is the imaginary part. So if you're saying it's purely imaginary, we are saying that this has to be 0. And if this is 0, the locus is a circle with center 0, 0 and radius of 2. Because the general formula of an equation of a circle with radius center 0, 0 is x squared plus y squared is equal to r squared. This is a circle with center 0, 0 and a radius of r. So I hope you understand. So what I've done is, how did I get the 2? I'm saying, well, x squared plus y squared is equal to 2 squared. So the radius is 2 and the the center is 0, 0, and the radius is 2.